Guys, today we are going to see hybridization problems, okay, which is comes under a unit 2 of polytechnic syllabus. So this hybridization problems, and everywhere it is asking, they are asking, so many problems are coming from this. So now we are going to see hybridization problems. The first one is the shape of this is I have taken so many questions from polytechnic TRB and some of the places also, so one or two questions will be there from that also. The shape of IF7 molecule. What is the shape? Iodine F7. So iodine is 7. Okay, valence electron is 7. Minus 7. So there is no lone pair of electrons, which is 0. Okay, and now we have to see 7 means what is the hybridization? SP3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 is there. What is the base structure for this? Pentagonal bipyramidal. This is the base structure. Okay, what is the thing they are given? Shape only they are asking. What is the shape now? Pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal bipyramidal. The second one, the structure of xenon F5 minus anion as predicted by VSPR theory is. What is the structure they are predicted for the xenon F minus? Xenon, you know that is a 8 valence electron, okay, 8 minus, here xenon F minus is there, xenon F5 minus is there, so minus means you have to add one electron and it becomes 9, okay, and minus 5, how many bonded atoms to that? 5 divided by 2, so we need to find the lone pair of electrons, how many lone pair of electrons? 2 lone pair of electrons. Plus, how many bonded atoms? 5. So, it is 7. This is also same. SP3D3. What is the structure? Pentagonal bipyramidal. Okay. How many lone pair of electrons? 2 lone pair of electrons is there. So, what is that exactly? Pentagonal planar. What is the structure? Pentagonal planar. The second, third one. In which of the following species, sulfur atom assumes SP3 hybrid orbitals? SO3, H2S, CS2, S8. In which of the following we need to check in this, in which of these sulfur atoms, SO3 is there, H2S is there, CS2 is there, S8, in which of these SP3 hybrid orbitals sulfur atom assumes the SP3, we need to check. SO3 sulfur 6 minus 3 minus 3, this is 3, another 3 is a divalent ion, so minus 3 divided by 2, 0 lone pair of electrons, so only what is there? 3 bonded atoms are there. So, what is that? SP3 means SP2. This is SP2. So, this is not SP3 hybrid orbitals. And second one, H2S. In this, they are asking sulfur atom. Think about sulfur atom. 6 minus 2. Okay, 6 minus 2. 2 atoms are there. Divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2, which is 2. 2 lone pair of electrons plus how many is there? 2 bonded atoms. 2 plus 2, 4, that is SP3. This is there, okay. H2S is there. And another one, CS2. CS2, if you see that, in that sulfur atom, they are asking. Central metal atom is C, but they are asking about the sulfur. So, 6 minus this one, another 2 is there. 2, this is also 4 divided by 2, 2 lone pair of electrons plus 2 atoms are there. Okay, 2 atoms are bonded. So, 4. This is also SP3. This is also SP3. The S8, by looking itself, it is there. It is not at all possible to get SP3 hybridization. So, what and all is their answer? Second and third. Hybridization of PCl5 molecule. PCl5 molecule. What is the hybridization? Okay. PCl5 molecule. If you don't know how to do it, you just check my previous video, hybridization tricks. In that, I will tell you clearly what is the formula, how to calculate like this. The phosphorus is a 5 valence electrons. Okay, nitrogen, phosphorus, like this it is coming. Okay, phosphorus is 5 minus how many bonded atom is there? 5 divided by 2. So, there is no lone pair of electrons plus 5. Bonded electron is 5. So, 5 means SP3D. Okay. What is that? SP3D. SP3D means base structure is this. What they are asking? SP3D. They are asking like that and that only. That is sufficient. This is answer. The type of hybridization CuN3O, ammonia, copper ammonium complex. in that they are asking what is the hybridization. Copper ammonium complex 2+. Okay, ammonia is a strongly bond. Copper is copper 2+. What is this one? Copper 2+ is D8. Copper is D9. Sorry, copper is D9. Copper zinc. Nickel copper zinc. Okay, D9. So D9 means how we have to arrange it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. D9 is like this. And here the ammonia is there. Actually, it's a strong ligand. It will pairing takes place, but there is no pairing electrons on there. It is not there. So what will happen? The remaining four will arrange like this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. sp3. So what will happen? This will be as it is. Okay, this last electron will shift to here, and remaining four, 1, 2, 3, 4, in these four places ammonia will get paired. Okay, these four places ammonia will get paired. What are all these places? D orbital, s orbital, and p orbital. So what is that? D1, s1, and p2. What is that? DSP2. D1, S1, and P2. DSP2. What is the hybridization? This is the hybridization. DSP2. If there are 5 electron, next question. If there are 5 electron pairs in the outer shell, then the structure and the bond angle as predicted by the Sidwick-Powell theory is. What is that? Outermost. What is that? Shape and angle. They are asking about a shape and angle. Okay. You see here. 5 electrons, they are said is a 5 electrons only. Outermost is the outermost shell is having a 5 electrons. If it is a 5 electrons, what is the shape? Even if it is a 5, then what will be the shape? I can easily say that is trigonal bipyramidal will be the shape. Okay, finally, 5 bonded atoms is there, means 5 bond pair is there, means what is that? Trigonal bipyramidal. What is the angle? If this one and this one and this one is 120 degree, and this is 90 degree. Okay, these two are the angles, and this is the answer. So answer is B. And next question, 7th question. Distorted trigonal bipyramidal geometry can result by involvement of which one of the following sets through sp3d hybridization? Which one of the following is sp3d hybridization? The same question. Okay, the same like this only. This will get, when this shape will get distorted. If there is a one lone pair of electron is there, then what will happen? This shape will get distorted. Okay, if there is any one lone pair of electron is there, then the shape will get distorted. What will happen? There is a repulsion between the bond pair and lone pair, so the bond will not be in that shape, so a little bit away from that, so that we call it as distorted shape. Okay, the distorted bond pair lone pair means it is a 5 bond pair we need. Okay, if we need this structure, means trigonal bipyramidal we need 5 bond pairs. In this 5 bond pair, if it is normally it is there, nothing will happen. So it is normally, if it is there, means distorted, we won't get it. There is a trigonal bipyramidal we will get. They are saying distorted. If it distorted means we need one lone pair of electrons, then it will get distorted and will form a distorted trigonal bipyramidal. Which has a maximum number of lone pair of electrons on the central atom? In the central atom, which one will have a maximum number of lone pair of electrons? See the option. The option itself we can easily say. Once the central metal atom, see the valence electron of the central metal atom. If the valence electron is high and the bonded atom is less, then the lone pair will be high. Okay, that is the easiest one. Okay, see here, everywhere xenon is there. We will take xenon. Xenon is having 8 valence electrons. Oxygen is having a 6 valence electron. Compared to that, xenon is more. So we will compare the xenon alone. 8 valence electron. In the 8, only 2 are bonded. Okay, here 6 are bonded. Here 4 are bonded. So this is the answer. I'll tell you, I have said this as a trick, but by formula, I will explain this also. Okay. Xenon F2. Xenon is 8 electrons are there, minus 2 bonded atoms divided by 2. How many lone pair of electrons now? 8 minus 2, 6 pi 2, which is equal to 3 lone pair of electrons. If you take a water H2O, O is the central metal atom, 6 valence electron, minus 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2. So 2 lone pair of electrons. If you see xenon F4, 8 bonded atoms, 8 valence electron minus 4 bonded atoms divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. This is also 2 lone pair of electrons. And xenon F6, 8 valence electron minus bonded atom is 6 divided by 2, which is equal to 2 by 2, which is equal to 1 lone pair of electron. Just having a maximum number of lone pair of electrons. Xenon F2. That is the formula. Okay, by using formula also, you can get the same answer. And the next one, the correct order of hybridization of the central atom in the following species, NH3, platinum chloride, Cl4, 2 minus, and PCl5 and PCl3. In these four compound, which one is having the right order, they are asking. If the question is like this, means you have to be answer very cleverly. No need to answer for all those things. You just check one or two, which you feel correct. You check that, and according to that, you check the options. Okay. So very well easy one is ammonia. You know, ammonia is very easy to find out. The ammonia is a, how many valence electron is 5 minus 3 divided by 2. So 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 1 lone pair of electrons plus 3. So sp3 hybridization. So ammonia is sp3 hybridization. You check wherever the sp3 hybridization is there. This is the only one option, just having a first sp3 hybridization. So we can omit all the three options. We can go to that option. If you have any doubt, check and the last one also, bcl3. And that is a very easy, it's a planar, trigonal planar structure. So boron is don't have any lone pair of electron, no need to check it. And three electrons are there. So sp2 means trigonal by planar structure. So that is a, if you want to check, I will check. Boron is a third, okay, 3 valence electron, 3, 0. This is a lone pair of electron is 0 plus bonded atom is 3. So 3 means sp2. So that is a trigonal planar. sp2. This is also sp2 is there. So that is the structure. And pcl5, p4, p4, platinum, d4, cl2. If you want to check, surely I can check it. Why, you know, these are all the things we can easily say. pcl5, you check the pcl5 also. pcl5, phosphorus, chlorine, cl5, phosphorus is 7. And minus 5 divided, sorry, minus 5 divided by 2 is equal to 0 plus 5 valence electron, you know, nitrogen, phosphorus, okay, 5 valence electron plus 5 is equal to 5 is there. So 5 means what is that? sp3d hybrid orbitals. Hybridization is sp3d. sp3d means this sp3d. See, check, this is also sp3d. So no need to check it. Okay, you can directly move to that answer. This is the answer. And next one, select the correct statement. BF3 and ammonia have the same dipole moment. Correct statement they are asking. BF3 and ammonia, just now we saw that ammonia is an sp3 hybridization. Okay, just now we saw ammonia is an sp3 hybridization. Sp3 hybridization means what is the structure? Tetrahedral in structure. This is having one lone pair of electron also. And how this is tetrahedral structure is having a dipole moment is there. Okay. So as I said, ammonia is having dipole moment. And what about the BF3? See, the BCl3 and BF3 both are the same structure. We saw that. So this is a planar structure. So BF3 is like this. Okay. If this is there, means one will be cancelled by another one will be cancelled by that. This is a zero dipole moment. Okay, this is not having a dipole moment, but this is having a dipole moment. This is nearly having a dipole moment, nearly 2, I think 1.5 like that. 1.5 like that dipole moment is there for ammonia. I'm not sure, but it's close to that. Dipole moment of ammonia is smaller than that of the BF3, which is smaller. This is smaller. This is also, there is no dipole moment at all. Okay, so this is also not right statement. This is also wrong statement. Okay, they are asking a correct statement. Okay, BF3, no dipole moment. BF3 molecule has a planar structure while ammonia molecule is a pyramidal structure. BF3 molecule is a trigonal planar and ammonia is a trigonal pyramidal. Okay, pyramidal molecule. So the trigonal is not missing, so it's not, at the most is not that much right. Okay. The nitrogen atom has unshared pair of electrons while the boron atom has a free vacant orbitals. valence orbital. Yes, of course. Hydrogen atoms having a unshared pair of electrons. Pair of electrons is there. So how much is there? Valence electron is 5. So unshared pair of electrons is there. Then the boron is also having a vacant orbitals. So this is right. This is the right answer. The decreasing order of repulsive interaction of electron pair. The lone pair, bond pair. Lone pair, lone pair, lone pair, bond pair, bond pair, bond pair. No, this is the answer. You know, we know very well that if lone pair is there, their repulsion is higher than the bond pair. If lone pair is there in any one of the atom, that's why if you see the ammonia molecule and tetrahedral shape of any methane, the bond angle, you know, compared to this and this, it will vary because of why, you know, this, because of this lone pair electron, this bond will be move away from that. The bond angle will change, will decrease, not as it is like here and here. Okay, this will change because of the lone pair of electrons. So the lone pair repulsion is high. So lone pair is repulsion is first, and then lone pair, bond pair, and then bond pair, bond pair. So the first option is right. And the next question, out of SO4 2 minus H2S SO4 S and SF2, in which molecule sulfur does not undergo sp3 hybridization? In this molecule, which one sulfur will not undergo, not undergo, we have to check. The first one, SO4 2 minus, sulfur is 6, minus 2 means plus 2 we need to add, so 8. Here 4 is there, minus 4 divided by 2, so 4 by 2 which is equal to 2 lone pair of electrons plus 4. Plus 4 bonded atoms, which is equal to 6, that is sp3d2 4 5 6. Okay, what they are asking, which is not undergo sp3 hybridization. So this is not a sp3 hybridization. Okay, and next one, sorry, this is a bivalent anion. So bivalent means 8 minus 4 minus 4 we need to do. So minus 4 minus 4 is 0. So there is no lone pair of electron in this case. Okay, there is no lone pair of electron in this case. 0 lone pair of electrons, only 4 bonded atoms will be there. So this is sp3. It will undergo sp3 hybridization. Okay, so another one, SO4 H2S. H2S, just now we saw that this will also undergo the sp3 hybridization. And if you want, you just go through that. Okay. 6 electrons plus 6 electron, 6 valence electron minus 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2, 2 valence, 2 lone pair of electrons plus 2 bonded atoms. So 4, that is sp3. Okay, this is also sp3. And SF4, S6 minus 4 divided by 2, which is equal to 2 by 2, which is equal to 1 plus 4 bonded atoms, which is equal to 5. So sp3 d will be there. Okay, sf4 it's not undergo the sp3 hybridization. You can easily say that. So which is the answer? The sf4 is not undergoes the sp3 hybridization. And last one, we will check once again the sf2. So everywhere if you check, sf4 is not present in that. If this is present, but SF4 2 minus is there. Okay, only SF2 is not checked. So I'll directly go to that option. 6 minus 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2, which is equal to 2. 2 lone pair of electrons plus 2, which is equal to 4. So sp3, this is also going for sp3, only that is the not going for the sp3 hybridization. In piperidin, the n hydrogen, so the n atom, the nitrogen atom has which type of hybridization? You have to check which type of hybridization this piperidin is going. Okay, if while seeing itself we can say easily, but anyway, I will explain. Nitrogen, here the atom is there. See, 1, 2, 3 atom is there, one lone pair of electron is there. So it's directly we can say this is a sp3 hybridization. Okay, sp3 hybridization. But anyway, we will check. Nitrogen is 5 valence electron minus, how many bonded atoms are there? 1, 2, 3 bonded atoms are there divided by 2. So 2 divided by 2, the 1 lone pair of electrons plus 3, which is equal to 4, which is equal to sp3. Okay, this is the sp3 hybridization. A sp3 hybridization or hybrid orbital contains how many s characters? See here, sp3 hybridization is there. Out of 4, 1 s character. So 1 by 4 s character is there. What is that answer? 1, 2, 3, 4 is there. In that 4, only 1 S character is there. So 1 by 4 is the S character. The structure of ICl2- is what? iodine is 7 minus structure is there, so plus 1 you need to add. So 8, if there is any negative sign is there, you need to add 1. So first itself we need to add 1. So we will get 8. And then how many bonded atoms are there? 2 bonded atoms are there. Minus 2 divided by 2. 8 minus 2, 6 divided by 2. So 3 lone pair of electrons plus 2. Okay, 2 bonded atoms. So 5. 5 means sp3d. Okay, sp3d. What is the structure? Trigonal bipyramidal. Okay, trigonal bipyramidal. In that, how many lone pairs of 3 lone pairs of electrons is there? So here also, 2 lone pair of electrons. So whether a linear is there, then we can select it. If linear is not there, so distorted trigonal bipyramidal. So because of the lone pair of electron, the structure will get distorted. So distorted trigonal pyramidal. Planar structures is shown by which are all the compound is shown planar structure. We need to check. If you see that CO32 minus carbon is having a 4 valence electron plus 2 is a 6 minus bonded atom is 3 divided by 2, which is equal to 3 divalent. I'm keep on forgetting that divalent means minus 3, so 0 valence electron. And plus how many bonded atom is there? 3 bonded atoms. If 3 bonded atom is sp2 is a planar structure, trigonal planar structure. This is the structure. This is a planar. And BCl3, as I said earlier, BC is a planar structure. And nitrogen silicon hydride. Here is a special case of this one. Okay, even though this is a nitrogen is having a lone pair of electron is there, this will be shared with the silicon of vacant d orbitals. Okay, this is shared with the vacant d orbital, so the structure will be not like this. If it is a like any other structure, if you take it, you know, CH3 like 4, if this structure means it looks to be like this, okay, lone pair of electrons will be like this, the structure will be like this. But in this case, the structure is as a planar structure. What is the structure? Planar structure. The planar structure is like this. Okay. It looks to be a silicon hydride. Silicon hydride. Here also silicon hydride. This is the structure. It's a special structure. So this is also planar. Keep it in the mind. So all of these are planar. In a molecule having a same central atom, the bond angle increases as the electronegativity of a surrounding atom decreases. With the help of above data, match the following. Okay. What they are saying, the central atom, you know, this is the central atom for these three. The bond angle increases as the electronegativity of the atom decreases. The electronegativity decreases means the bond angle will increase. So we should know what is the status of the trend of the electronegativity for this halogen atoms. The electronegativity we know very well, which is more electronegativity. Now, fluorine is more, and then chlorine, bromine, and then iodine. So which is the least electronegative? Okay, least bond angle increases as the electronegativity decreases. It will reverse case. If it is least, so bond angle will be high. So this is high, and the next one is bromine. The next highest one is 101, goes to this, and last one it goes to here. So the bond angle is just inversely proportional to the electronegativity. So what we need to come to know from this, okay, bond angle which is inversely proportional to the electronegativity of an atom. Okay, and last three questions are there. Why does the repulsion is greater in lone pair as compared to the lone pair bond pair and bond pair? Why? The reason we need to say, the lone pair electrons in the molecule occupies more space as compared to the bonding pair of electrons. Yes, of course. The lone pair electrons, what will happen? It will occupy the more space compared to the bonding pair. If the bond pair is there, means it will take only one place, but in the lone pair means it takes too much space. Okay, that's why the shifting takes place. This is the right one, and we'll check another. The bond pair electrons in the molecule occupy more space as compared to the lone pair. No, bond pair will not take a more place, only lone pair will take a more place. This is wrong. Both 1 and 2, this is also wrong. Bond pair repulsion is greater than lone pair. No, lone pair repulsion is greater than the bond pair. Okay, this is also wrong. Nickel cobalt, nickel chloride, and cobalt complexes, and cesium oxide, and sodium peroxide, and these are also some of the compounds I've given. Okay, cobalt complex. total number of paramagnetic compounds. You have to check all the compounds and we need to say the paramagnetism. But you see, one of the trick I'll tell you, if when the paramagnetism will happen, if the ligand, you know, the ligand is a strong ligand, the pairing will take place, so that will be diamagnetic. If it is a weak ligand, it undergoes a paramagnetic. Which and all weak ligand, you just check it, that and all paramagnetic, that there is no doubt in that. So this is a weak ligand, chlorine is a weak ligand, so that will be paramagnetic. This fluorine is also weak ligand, so this is also paramagnetic. So 2, we know that it's a paramagnetic. Okay, in this ammonia, ammonia is a strong ligand. Which and all strong ligand? Carbonyl and ammonia, these two are strong ligand. Chlorine, fluorine and a weak ligand. So this compound will undergo the paramagnetic. Okay, already we found two compound. So this one and this one. The next one, which and all which are not there, these two we need to find. See here, the cesium oxide. Cesium oxide. Cesium oxide is a superoxide. This is the superoxide. How it looks to be, you know, O2 minus. Okay, this is a superoxide, you say. If superoxide is there, means this superoxide contains free electrons. Superoxide contains free electrons. But if you go through the sodium peroxide, means Na2O2 means sodium peroxide. This is a derivative of hydrogen peroxide. You know the hydrogen peroxide, no? Instead of hydrogen, here sodium is there. Sodium peroxide is having... that is O2 2 minus is there. This is the structure. Okay, if you remove this, okay, this O2 2 minus does not contain free electron. This does not contain free electron. Which one is contain free electron? Only superoxide. This is called superoxide. Okay, this is superoxide. And if